चंद्राय राधिकाय कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय सर्वभक्ताय पंचाभूतश्च त्रिपासिन्दुभ्यैव च पितानां पापनेभ्यो वैष्णवे श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि श्री गौरभक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम
हरे कृष्णा। सो टुमारो वी विल सेलिब्रेट द पूर्ण व्यास पूजा एंड द डिसअपीयरेंस डे ऑफ सनातन गोस्वामी पाद। टुमारो वी विल सेलिब्रेट द व्यास पूजा एंड सनातन गोस्वामी पाद डिसअपीयरेंस डे व्यास नारायण स्वयं। सो दिस व्यास पूजा हेल्ड बाय नित्यानंद प्रभु इन द हाउस ऑफ श्रीनिवास ठाकुर एंड महाप्रभु आल्सो वाज देयर। सो आफ्टर द हरिनाम संकीर्तन इन द हेड द हाउस ऑफ श्रीनिवास ठाकुर महाप्रभु हिमसेल्फ सेड दैट टुमारो वी विल सेलिब्रेट द व्यास पूजा एट योर हाउस। सो द आविर्भाव अपीयरेंस डे ऑफ गुरु एंड आचार्य इट इज कॉल्ड द व्यास पूजा। सो महाप्रभु इट ही इज सेइंग हियर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ व्यास द पर्सन हु ब्रॉडकास्ट सो who spread the katha of Bhagwan everywhere. This is called the Vyas. So Mahaprabhu said to Nityananda Prabhu, Nityananda Prabhu tell one thing, where we will celebrate the Vyas Puja tomorrow, because there is so much expenditure for celebrating Vyas Puja. First, you have to celebrate the decorate the Thakur ji. Then, biggest is there that you have to spend so much in prasad. The prasad must be so nice quality because the devotee will come aja yuddhe rishi shraddhe pratakale brahmane so what is the meaning here actually aja means bakri Bakra. So Aja means when Bakri and then the God So when the fight between hell between gods so we see that they are going to die today each other after fighting each other And earlier, the Sant Mahatma, whenever they celebrate or when they disappear, so at that time they don't used to spend so much. They just used to do to take two fire stick and just do swa swa swa, and there was no arrangement of prashas there. Everybody used to take their madhukari, the beggars, the alms, and they distributed it. But if you go to the Mayavadi ashram, it is not happening like that. But it happens in the Gaudiya Math. They used to go door to door and collect some rotis and alms, and they celebrate like this. Because Mayavadi sannyasi used to say, that Mayavadi sannyasi will not touch the fire. This is the philosophy of Mayavadi. The sannyasi cannot prepare food. And whatever he will take, so he will have to fill up his stomach with that only. Big celebration. We used to celebrate Hari Katha Mahotsav, but in our Gaudiya Math, Prashad, they used to arrange so much Prashad and many things. So we used to spend so much time there. So Rishi Shraddh, earlier, whenever any Sant Mahatma he disturbed, there was no so much big celebration. They used to just something, and there was no arrangement of Prashad. When husband and wife, they quarrel each other. But they used to laugh and joking each other. So there is too much expenditure in their marriages also, in husband and wife marriage. And they are so much give the rain. It will not rain. So Mahaprabhu is saying in this way, no, we will celebrate the Vyas Puja tomorrow. So whatever the arrangements of the prasad and everything, we will manage that. Who will do that? Mahaprabhu always used to call Nityanand Shripad. What Nityanand? Hold the hand of give it to Mahaprabhu. So Mahaprabhu said, there is nothing at the home in the Srinivas Thakur. So what he will do? How will he? Because he is so much poor, how he can manage? Gurudev used to say that he doesn't have a rat in his house, so it means he doesn't have any kinds of grain in his house. So his all house is open air, like there is nothing, everything is open there. So at that time, Shri hold the feet of Mahaprabhu. He is Prabhu, you are the Sakshat Narayan yourself. Wherever you are, so there is no shortage of Lakshmi, because always Lakshmi decides always with you. So please give this service to me. Srinivas Thakur very humbly said, hey Nityanand, hey Gaurasundar, please give this service to me. Then Mahaprabhu said, okay, yatha ichcha tatha kuru, whatever your wish, okay, do it. So Srinivas Thakur, he announced, and Mahaprabhu announced that tomorrow at the house of Srinivas Thakur, we will celebrate the Vyas Puja. So in the morning, all the devatas, they took the form of the human beings, and they enter into the home of Srinivas Thakur. And they carried all many kinds of grains and prashad. And all the home of Srinivas Thakur was filled up with all kinds of things, vegetables, grains and ornaments. Because Bhagwan always take the weight of Bhakt. He take all the responsibility of the Bhakt. Bhagwan is himself is saying, Ananyascha Chintato Mam. So Srinivas Thakur is the topmost devotee of Lord. So everything was arranged in the home of Srinivas Thakur. Everything was managed by Bhagwan. And then according to the wish of Mahaprabhu, so they made the Vyas Panchak, they made the sitting place of Vyas. Then Mahaprabhu and Nityanand Prabhu and Adyutacharya, all the devotees, they started Nam Sankirtan there, because in the Kali Yuga, what is the meaning of worship? That Nam Sankirtan. From morning to noon, they were performing the Nam Sankirtan. That all was observed in Nam Sankirtan. No one conscious about his body. Everybody was performing Nam Sankirtan. When the noon came, because these all devotees had did the Kirtan, so there is so much hard work they have did. Because there is so much hard work in playing Mridang and doing Kirtan. That's why Mahaprabhu indication to Nityanand and Advait, okay, the Kirtan is done. Now give the Pushpanjali to Thakurji. So who they are offering the Pushpanjali? So who will give the Nityanand Prabhu? Nityanand Prabhu. So who will give the offering today? So first, because Nityanand Prabhu, Madhvendrapuri, Lakshmipati Tirth. So he is the disciple of Lakshmipati Tirth. Some are saying that he is the disciple of Madhvendrapuri. So there is no need to argument here. Some are saying the Madhvendrapuri, some are saying that he is the disciple of Lakshmipati Tirth. So Mahaprabhu said, "Hey Shripad, you start the Vyas Puja first." Nityanand Prabhu, you started Vyas Puja first because you are the topmost amongst devotee. So what Nityanand Prabhu did, he took the garland. So he hold the garland for 1 minute, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. So Mahaprabhu said, "Shripad, offer this garlands to Vyas Dev, because everybody is waiting for you. Everybody is in the queue because everybody is so much hungry. So there is rat in everybody's stomach now. So rat is jumping is everybody's stomach now. So everybody is hungry. So you do make it quick." So when Mahaprabhu told him 4 or 5 times, then Nityanand Prabhu gave that garland to Mahaprabhu. Bolo Nityanand Prabhu ki jai, Sachinandan Gaur. So all the devotees said, "Why?" So what is the view actually? What is the philosophy? Nityanand Prabhu said himself, it is mentioned in the scriptures, mool origin of the Jagat Guru. Krishna is the origin Acharya. Who is the Jagat Guru? Krishna. That's why according to our lineage, Krishna Haite Chaturmukh. So this is our discipline, Guru Parampara. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the origin Guru. And the Krishna is the Mool Guru, the origin of all Guru. In this Kali Yuga, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, the Krishna himself, appeared in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And how his worship is celebrated? By Nam Sankirtan. Krishna means the who is not Krishna, he is the Gaur Varna. So how his worship will be held in of Nam Sankirtan? Who is his Anga, body's part? Nityanand Advaitacharya, he is his body part. Srinivas Thakur. Who the Pashyat? Gadadhar, Rup Sanatan, they all are the associates, especially Gadadhar, Shakti Tattva. And who was the Astra, weapons? The Nam Sankirtan is the weapon in this Kali Yuga. So by this Nam Sankirtan, in the Archan will be done by this Nam Sankirtan. That's why Mahaprabhu, from since morning to 12 midday, he was performing Nam Sankirtan, the chanting holy name. So Nityanand Prabhu, he proved that Krishna is the Jagat Guru. Even Tattva Vichar, Lakshmipati Devi. Atta Tattva Vichar, at the Tattva Vichar, Nityanand Prabhu is the disciple of Lakshmipati Tirtha. And Mahaprabhu is the disciple of Ishwar Puripad. Mahaprabhu Puripad, Ishwar Puripad, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Nityanand Prabhu is the disciple of Lakshmipati Tirtha. But Nityanand Prabhu is worshipping Mahaprabhu. That's why it is saying, Doi Prabhu Seve Mahaprabhu or Advaitacharya. Doi Prabhu Nityananda Prabhu and Advaitacharya and Mahaprabhu Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Mahaprabhu. So Advaitacharya and Nityananda Prabhu. So they are servicing Mahaprabhu because Mahaprabhu Prabhu means Maha. Maha means great. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th canto, Navyogin Samvad, the conversation of Navyogin, in this Kali Yuga, Krishna himself will appear in the form of Gaurang. And there is a definition is giving there that the same Krishna, how he will descend in this land. That's why it is showed the Krishna Puja. Nityananda Prabhu is the Guru Tattva. And Krishna, Nityananda Prabhu is non-different from Krishna. If you enter into Tattva Vichar, Swayam Roop and Swayam Prakash. He is a Swayam Roop. And then it came Taditatmak Roop and Vichar. According to the Sanatana Shiksha, it is very nicely described. Mahaprabhu is saying himself. And Sanatana Goswami part to asked to Mahaprabhu that who is the Bhagwan in Kali Yuga. Then Mahaprabhu hiding himself. That Sanatana Goswami Pad said that the sun cannot be hid by the clouds. So in this way, so he indicated that Krishna himself is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This way Nityananda Prabhu, that the Mool Mahaprabhu, the Krishna. Vistarath, who is spread? This is the meaning of Vyas. Who is spread the katha everywhere? They are called Vyas. That's why it is called Vyas Peeth. On the seat of Vyas, this is called the Vyas Peeth. Gurudev is sitting here. So we are sitting on the chair. On the asana of Vyas. So that's why he is Vyas asana. So that's the asana where Acharya sit. This is called the Vyas Peeth, the Vyas asana. Then who is the Mool? Mool Vyas. Krishna is the Mool Vyas. Origin. He is non-different from Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the origin Vyas. So who is glorifying Gita? In the Gita, it is said, Shri Bhagwan Uvacha. Uvacha means said. So Bhagwan said himself, Hey Arjun, do this and that. So Bhagwan himself, sometime Bhagwan, it is said in the Brahma Suti. Hare Krishna, can you hear me? Hari Bol, can you hear me? How we can get the mercy of Bhagwan? Then we can understand the Ishwar Tattva. When Bhagwan himself manifested in our heart and got to know us that Nainatma Prochni Lavyo. Tanu means the body. When Bhagwan himself made ourselves and by his mercy, how he will manifest in our heart? By his mercy. Just like we worship the by his Ganga water, in the same way, when Bhagwan gives his mercy and manifested his all power in our heart, then we can realize Bhagwan. Bhagwanji himself is saying, Vaidha Vidya knowledge, you cannot understand me. So the further katha I am describing, because the well will be ring here. So Vyas Dev is saying Vyas Puja. So who Vyas is talking about? Which Vyas they are talking about? Krishna Dwapayan Vyas. Krishna Dwapayan Veda Vyas. Who is he? Is an Shaktyavesh. Gyan Vesh. Who is the avatar of the? So the Dwapayan Vyas is whose avatar? Whose incarnation is this? Shaktyavish avatar is a Gyanavish avatar. He is the incarnation of Gyanavish. When Bhagwan manifested all his knowledge in his heart, just like somebody observed or captured by the ghost, so that person cannot do anything. He is not giving his introduction. He is giving the ghost is giving his introduction in this body. That I am this and that. So in this way. So when Bhagwan manifested his all power and all his knowledge in his heart, so that's why Vyas is called Gyanavesh Avatar, the avatar of knowledge. All kinds of Ved, Puran, Upanishad is manifested in his heart by the mercy of Bhagwan. Naradishi is called Bhaktavesh Avatar. So Bhagwan manifested all bhakti in his Naradishi's heart. Krishna Dwapayan Veda Vyas, he is of a Bhagwan. His life is stick. Because it is mentioned in the scriptures whom we are going to worship. So who is that person? Like the Maharaj. So if somebody asks that, where he got the birth and who is his guru? So if somebody says, so nobody know, then what to do? What the use of that worship? Then if I'm going to preaching in the foreign country, to me. If I'm going to preach in the Brazil and some of ask to my disciple that who is my guru, so he said, no, there is a person who was in Mathura, he gave the diksha of that person. So this is not true. Who is the sannyas guru and diksha guru of Srila Prabhupada Swami Maharaj? So somebody asked, there was a Brahmana of Mathura who gave the sannyas to Swami Prabhupada. So I asked that sannyasi was, that's the sannyasi who gave the to Swami Prabhupada, he was grast or sannyasi? So he said, I don't know about him. So the person who is not aware about his Gurudev, so what the use of that? Are you getting? So whom we are going to worship, so we should have some knowledge about him. Am I audible to you? Please check Hare Krishna, Hare Bol. So Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Goswami, where he took the birth. So if there are disciples not aware about that, so what the use of going to Vyas Puja? And we are going to offering Pushpanjali. many people used to started. They are starting the giving Pushpanjali, and somebody asked that where he got birth. Oh, I don't know where he got birth. So it's not like that. We shouldn't do like this. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he took the initiation from Ishwar Puripath, Mahaprabhu went to the birthplace of Ishwar Puripath. To worship, you should know about his life history. Now that we are going to glorify him, it is good, but we in the same way we are going to worship Vyasadeva, so we should know the life history of Vyasadeva. We should hear that. What is his full name? Krishna Dwapayan Ved Vyas. Krishna Dwapayan Ved Vyas. His full name is of Vyas. Because he is the avatar, incarnation of Krishna. And he was the complexion of Krishna, his complexion like Krishna. Krishna himself incarnated in the Avesh. Because he took the birth in the Tapu, the Iceland. That's why he became Veda Vyas, Dwapayan. He took the birth in the Tapu. And he spread the Ved. He described the Ved Vyas. And he manifested so many kinds of Puranas, Shruti, Smriti. Upanishad. He manifested 11,108 Upanishad. And he retained Vedanta Sutra, 550 Vedanta Sutra. He manifested Mahabharata. What is Mahabharata called? Pancham Ved. It is the history, itihas. And it's called the Pancham Ved, fifth Ved. So there are so many kinds of scriptures he has manifested. That's why he is called Ved Vyas. But after manifesting all kinds of scriptures, he didn't got the peace of mind. So it is mentioned in the first canto, fifth chapter, which is described there, the conversation between Vyas and Narad. So Vyasdev himself said, Narashi himself said, "Hey Vyas, I know what is the suffering of your mind. I know why are you so much worrying? Why your mind is less restless?" Narashi said, "Vyas, I know what is the cause of your restlessness, because you have manifested scriptures. But after hearing that, your mind is confused, because whatever you have wrought, there is no clarification that who is Bhagwan. So you haven't written that. If you read Brahma Purana, the Brahmaji is Bhagwan himself. If you read Shiv Purana, you will think, oh, Shiva is Bhagwan himself. If you read Vishnu Purana, you will think Vishnu Bhagwan himself. So if Bhagwan is one, then what is the need to describe it? There are so many granthas. Why it is saying in all the scriptures that he is Bhagwan, that is Bhagwan? And the second, you have not clarified object, target. What is the topmost object, the prushad of Bhagwan, jivas? So your dharma, artha, kam, moksha you have written, but what is after liberation, the mukti? You haven't described that. So what is the pancham purushartha? And different Purans, there are so many kinds of leelas describing that. So people are so much confused. where Krishna took the birth, who is his mother, parents. Here it, you are writing Devaki Nandan, Yashoda Nandan, and mother, father is one only. Yashoda Nandan, somewhere you are writing Devaki Nandan. So that's why people are so much confused. Vasudev Nandan. Hari, who is his father, parents? So people get confused. And second, after the Krishna taking over Krishna Dwarika Leela, if he described what we get systematically, so people can understand. If you read the Garga Sanhita, you will be confused that who is Krishna. Dwarika Leela, Mathura Leela, and Vrindavan Leela, everything is there, is khichdi like, everything is submerged. You won't be able to understand. You will be so much confused after reading this. If you read Garga Sanhita, if you read other Purans and Garga Sanhita, and there are many, so much big stories there that you will be confused after hearing that. Everything is rubbish there, like he mixed up everything. And you have not clarified the topmost Leela of Bhagwan, the Ras Leela and other Leela. So you have not clarified this, that where the Ras was held. What is the Ras actually? The topmost Leela of Bhagwan is Ras Leela. So where is this Ras Leela was held? In the Dwarika, in the Mathura, in the Vrindavan. Where it is that? There was a one speaker, Krishna, when Krishna was in Dwarika, that I played the flute. Piece was assembled. So in the Dwarika, I thought that there are, I have 16,108 queens. So I thought, so Krishna is thinking, if I play the flute here, so what happens? I just check. So Krishna started playing flute. When Krishna started flute, so one queen was thinking, oh, there is a knight, so what should I do? So I have to put on the nightie so that I can go, because there is a knight. I have to put on the night dress. So when Krishna came from Vrindavan to Mathura, so he left his peacock feather and his flute. So people is not aware about that, because you will see many people here. So after when Krishna was came from Vrindavan, so he never put on peacock feather and flute. He never took that. It is mentioned in the scriptures. Vrindavan Krishna has so that's why he's put on peacock feather and he kept flute. Peacock feather and the flute, why Krishna took that? If somebody has knowledge about that, little bit, you tell. Why? Kept the morpang, the peacock feather, because there is a name of Radha in that. Shuk Sari conversation. Shuk is saying, Shuk is taking the side of Krishna. He is saying Krishna is having peacock feather on his head. Why? Because Sari is saying why he has taken the peacock feather in his hand. So Shuk said, because he has the name of Radha. If you take the peacock feather and you see that very and intentionally, so you will see there is a Radha name is mentioned there in the peacock feather. And what Sari is saying? Shuk is that our Krishna is playing so much beautiful flute. And Sari is saying, what is he is playing? So he is saying he is playing the Radha name.
Venu Gita Gake Radhe. राधे राधे बोली मुरली टाकी वे मोदियो ईश्वरी नाम
भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर ही डिड द कीर्तन ब्यूटिफुल कीर्तन चिंतामणि में राधा कुंड देयर इज अ श्लोक इज देयर इज अ कीर्तन ब्यूटिफुल कीर्तन इन द वृंदावन कृष्णा इज हैविंग द मोर द पीकॉक फेदर इन द फ्लूट व्हाट इज द स्पेशल रीजन व्हाट इज द रीजन टू हैव अ फ्लूट बिकॉज ही वुड लाइक टू ब्रेक द मान ऑफ द गोपीज एंड फॉर कॉलिंग द गोपीज दैट्स So he has clarified in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So by playing the flute, Krishna has manifested the love in the heart of gopis. So Krishna, by playing the flute, and he has aroused the transcendental calm in the heart of gopis. And the second reason why he would like to break the man of the gopis or so the vansi the flute is called amog astra of Krishna. Sometimes this flute is also unable to break the man of Radha ji. He can break the man, he can call everybody, but for Radha sometimes Banti is unable to work. Even Brahmas is also failed. In the lecture of Gurudev, one of the lecture of Gurudev, he said very very beautiful katha. He said in the hostel somewhere, when Radha ji was in Man, what Krishna did, that how can I break the Man of Radha ji. So at that time what Krishna did, he started playing flute. Radha said, okay, I cannot hear the sound of your flute. I will put cotton in my ear. So if you are sitting somewhere and you are not listening my katha, so what happened to you? Nothing. So the person who has heard, so he will nodding is something. But the person who is not listening, so he won't do anything. So that's why Radha ji, she put the cotton on in his ear. And she was not able to hear the sound. Now what Radha is doing? She put the cotton in his ear. Now there was no sound was going inside his ear. But now how Radha ji can, now how Krishna can break the man of Radha ji? So this is the work of flute, that it always break the man of Radha ji. But now Radha ji is not able to hear the sound of flute. Now how what Krishna do? Radha ji was in Man. Radha ji left Krishna and she moved forward. And Krishna said, my vanshi got failed, my brahmastra is failed. What Krishna did? He called the yog maya. He remembered the yog maya. Krishna remembered the yog maya. So when Radhika Rani was going from the forest, so what is there was a very narrow road. So at the time what happened, yog maya, she took the form of a snake, black snake. Now the eyes of that snake is so much big eye, red eyes. Radha ji cannot go neither left nor right, because it is really hard to go to cross this snake. So at the time what Radha ji did, she was saying, Krishna Krishna Mahabaho, hey Krishna, hey Mahabaho, please help me because with this snake. So what happened, Radha Rani man was broken and she hug the Krishna, return back and hug the Krishna. So in the way Yog Maya helped to break the man of Radha Rani. That's why our Raghunath Goswami is written. So this reptile, the snakes, the creature of all the Vrindavans, what are they? They are so much dear to Mukund, and they are always favorable for leelas of Krishna, not unfavorable. They are favorable for Krishna's leela. Externally, we are seeing that snacks is unfavorable. The loin is unfavorable of leelas, but still they are always supporting in leela of Krishna. When Radha ji is avisar means. So, avisar means when she was walking on the night, going to meet with Krishna at the night. The loin is roaring. So Radha ji little bit fear, but at that time when the loin is roaring, he is not so much wild. He is just doing that leela. That yog maya himself. So yog maya is trying to support the meeting for Radha and Krishna. Brahma and other big devatas. So in the Vrindavan, so they are so much praying for Radha and Govind service. So this is all leela, let's describe them. So the katha we were describing on a different Krishna and the Vedavyas we were talking about. So Vedavyas of Krishna himself, which is he is the Avesh avatar of Krishna, Gyanavesh avatar. And where he took the birth? In the Tapu Dweep. That's why he is called Dwaipayan. Once what happened, Parashar Rishi, he had to cross the Yamuna. So the Kevat who was dead, I am so running my boat from Rishi has to cross Yamuna. So he said that please help me to cross Yamuna. So the boatman said, I am so much tired. Okay, don't worry, I have one of my daughter. So her name was Matsyaganda. So why her name became Matsyaganda? Because she took the birth of fish. Because sometimes what happened, there was an apsara, so she missed what we call in the child, what is called, you know, and see when. Okay. Okay. Embryo. That case was happened. Embryo was swelled by the. That's why her name became Matsyaganda. So Kevat, that the boatman, nourishment that lady, because she took the birth from the body of the lady, there was so much smell is coming of fishes. That's why her name came so much beautiful. But actually she was smelling of fishes because she got the birth from the body of the fish. Daughter, he is so do one thing, cross the river. Please help him to cross the Yamuna. So the Matsyaganda, she took the boat and Parashar Rishi seated on that. The merit with Shantanu, Maharaj Shantanu. So Vishvakatha is also added in that. There is a Mahabharata Katha because the going to over now. That's why her name became. Uh, because he has manifested so many kinds of Ved and Puran. So in the conversation with one Narad, so he has performed the follows the bhakti yoga, and when he followed the bhakti yoga, so he took the darshan of Bhagwan Sakshat Bhagwan himself. So it is not easy to write the so himself he realized Bhagwan leelas. Maybe you are following karma yoga, jnana yoga, whatever you are doing, but without the bhakti yoga you cannot take the darshan of Bhagwan. Krishna is ajanma, but still he took the birth from the womb of mother. Bhagwan is saying in the and karth, my birth and karma, transcendental person who knew, he knew about it, so they cannot take birth again and again, and they will take after that. So by the mercy of Narada and after, he wrote everything. And the latest Puran he wrote Bhagavatam. And in the first Bhagavatam he wrote Eta Chan Shakla Punsa Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. He wrote this. So reading his all, everybody became confused, but the person who wrote Srimad Bhagavatam, they got the clear vision. So after reading so many granthas, you will be confused. So that's why it is the topmost granth is Bhagavatam. So the essence of all kinds of Ved Puran is Srimad Bhagavatam, and somebody get engaged his mind to the Srimad Bhagavatam, so there is no need to study or other kinds of grantha. So the person who is eating so many beautiful in the Mathura, so they will not like jaggery. So in the person who has interest, who has developed interest in Srimad Bhagavatam, so they will not read any other grantha. Always speak the Bhagavad Katha, because there are so many beautiful kathas of Bhagwan. When we will die, nobody knows. So we will talk about here and there.
You speak the katha of nectar and katha of Bhagwan. There are very, very, very of Bhagwan.
How Krishna is playing with the sakhas, with his friend. So speak this katha, Sakhyarat katha, Basalaras katha, Madharas katha. So there are many beautiful katha. So hearing the katha, this such kathas, your all lust will go away, and the prem will be manifested, the love will be manifested in your heart. So hearing this katha, Puran katha, and hearing their katha, so what is the use of that? That's why the essence of all kinds of Vedas is Srimad Bhagavatam. The taste in Srimad Bhagavatam once, so there is he won't get taste in other kathas. Because we don't have taste, so that's why we are asking, please tell us Puran katha, this katha and that katha. We have read so much Ramayana, so please tell us different new katha. There was a disciple, he goes to his guru and said, please tell me, sir. He said, Ramayana katha. Well, no, Ramayana I have heard so many times, please tell me different katha. So he said, okay, Ram killed Sita, so yeah, I have heard this, tell me the latest. So it is not like that. Actually, the people are developing new taste. So what is mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam? Eta Chansh Kunsa
Dharma
Arta
कल्याण नहीं। सो बाय धर्म अर्थ काम मोक्ष पर्सन कैन नॉट गेट हिज कंप्लीट गोल। इट इज डिस्क्राइब्ड इन द भागवतम। उद्धव एंड मैनी मैनी ग्रेट डिवोटीज हु आर सो मच सफरिंग फॉर दैट लव। सो यू हैवंट हर्ड अबाउट दैट लव। Beautiful shloka is this. So you tell the stories of Radhaji's beautiful love, Bhramar Geet. How beautiful katha is that? So hearing that katha, what happened? Your heart will be melted. These are very beautiful katha. That's why it is said. And always said the Krishna katha as it is. Vrindavan katha, Mathura katha, Dwarka katha. So when Vyasdev manifested the latest Puran, Srimad Bhagavatam, so he wrote there every katha sequentially in a process. That's why his name became Krishna Dwapan Veda Vyas. Manifested so many kinds of Vedas. This is the depth of his. So Vyasdev, we were not satisfied. Who is modifying all the kathas of Vyasdev? Just like Vishwanath Chakradipa, so very beautiful Nectarian katha. Jeev Goswami Tika, Vishwanath Chakradipa Tika, they have described beautifully. Now there is no need to read other granthas. And Vishwanath Chakravarti, he described so many kinds of leela. There are four kinds of leela. There are two granths of Vishwanath Chakravarti, the Prem Samput, and other is Chamatkar Chandrika. So you won't get this kinds of granth anywhere. Rup Goswami Parad Granth, Lalit Madhav, Vedagna Madhav Granth, they are beautiful granth. That's why our Goswami was the Acharyas. They have described the Bhagavad Katha and modified that. They have so much modified that. That's why Lalit Madhav, Vedagna Madhav, and after that Vishwanath Chakravarti. And he manifested so many kinds of granth also. How beautiful granthas he manifested, how beautiful shlokas he quoted. If you read that grantha, so your whole day will pass. From morning to evening, evening to night. When the time is passing on, you don't know. You are. So you used to earth Radha Kunda, Sham Kunda, Govardhan Ashtakam, many kinds of Ashtakam. And after that, they have told so many beautiful grants. Just like our Acharya Pad used to come, so they manifested so many granthas. If you have to enter into the Tattva Siddhanta, so read Madhurya Kandamani by Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad. There is no need to read that Puran.